7:58 before I started this. I don't know if it's the time of day or my windows being open, but I can't get this light to stay where it's supposed to stay, which is right there. So stop being in shadow. All right. Chank. Hello, everyone. Today, I'm going to be talking about Cenk Uygur. So let me start this again. Hello, everyone. I finally got my light together. If it goes in and out, I don't really care. But I printed these papers, this and I printed this. Cenk Uygur wants to be the president of the United States. It can't happen. Now, I'm supporting him running. But the reason that it can't happen is because Congress, and he is incorrectly stating that Congress amended the Constitution to allow for natural citizens to run for president of the United States. That's what he's saying. That is not what the 14th Amendment is. 14th Amendment is to give them equal rights as citizens. It did not give you a right to run for the presidency. It is two separate things. The reason they did the amendment is because, in the first place, is because black people were slaves. I'm not even going to go into that. So they added in the rest of everybody else that migrated to this country and came in legally through the immigration process. The United States Constitution covers you. The United States Constitution does not cover a migrant, because a migrant has not been given permission to be in the United States, even though temporary protected status is applying to them. Human rights are applying to them. But the rest of the Constitution doesn't cover them, because a lot of them have come here under ill-gotten means or fraud. And the Constitution does cover that. But that's not what this is for. I just want people to understand and pass this video around that Cenk Uygur and everybody else who's on the list that I showed you the other day, because there are a lot of people running for president. Let me get that list real fast. Lots of people running for president. All that's going to be cut. You won't see it. I try not to make these videos longer, so when I got to get up and skirt around and walk around, there's no need looking at all that. Okay, so I showed you yesterday that I am on the, I'm registered to run for president. Okay, these are all the people, a list of registered 2024 presidential candidates. And there's my name there, Golda D. Harris, highlighted. However, I also downloaded the list of all the other people that are running for president in 2024. And there are a lot of us. There, every year, every 4 years, this happens. This is 14 pages, back-to-back names of people that are running for president of the United States. So when I hear people say nobody's running, or they look at me as if this is not an epiphany. People have been running, but you never get to see the people that are running for president of the United States, because media is owned by three companies. Because I think some of them companies were taken over, if I'm not mistaken. So I support Cenk Uygur running. I don't support him as being the president, not just because he can't be the president, but because, let's just say we make Cenk the president and we do away with the United States Constitution and the reason that they said that. He gets in there, and then the 25 million immigrants, the people that have come to this country legally, because there's more than 25 million here, but you kind of don't count if you're not on the census. This is what I say about black people. Well, they have us at 13%. Because the majority of us are not on the census. and the majority of us are not voting. So the reason why he can't be, and why I would never support him or anybody else who migrated in who's in immigration in this country, is because it is dangerous. How's it dangerous? Well, let's say Cenk has good intentions. They allow him to become the president. And then while he's president, he changes the Constitution with the rest of the immigrants that are in Congress. Yes? Now you no longer have a standing working constitution that says people from another country cannot come here and enforce their upbringing, their principles, their laws, their rules, their policy upon American soil. Don't you know that's why they enslaved me? That's why they enslaved my ancestors. That's how I became Black American. I'm proud to wear Black American. I don't have a problem with it. I know that I'm Nigerian and Blackfeet Native American, but that was taken away from me by this government, who owes me reparations for it. Agree or not, it's the fact. So I'm proud to be Black American. Because this is the only land that we have. And Cenk said, you want us here as second-class citizens. You're not second-class citizens. You're not. You are an American citizen. Now, when you talk about classes, that has to do with money and your stature. And Cenk is a millionaire. Back when he was a capitalist, working for capitalists. Now, he doesn't like what they've done and what they, for whatever reason, he no longer likes what they've done. I don't know if there was a deal gone bad against Turkey and he couldn't stand it and he didn't want to be bothered with them. And he had this platform putting progressives up. But whatever his reasons are, I don't know, because I haven't been at the beginning of when he did all that. He showed it on his platform that he used to work for the companies that I showed you in my other video. And that he gave an opinion and they didn't like his opinion and they kicked him out. It's the same thing that happened with Donald Trump with Democrats, because Donald Trump is a Democrat. He may be running as a Republican. He is still a Democrat. And people like him and Cenk want to do away with the Constitution. But the only thing the Constitution protects us is the right to not be taken over by another country. So it's just like the Hispanics now. What is that man's name? Oh, I can't remember his name. A senator complaining that the process to allow immigration is taking too long.
If you're a straight white Christian man, you're the only one that's safe. This is white supremacy and fascism happening in our country and in many other states. I'm asking you, how can such degenerate men be elected into office? I'll tell you why. Because they reflect who we are. They represent the principles that this nation was built upon. The principles of white supremacy. The principles of colonizers. The principles of enslavers. The principles of people who robbed, raped, and committed genocide against indigenous people. That's who we are today. That's who we always were, and that's who we are today, and that's why we have no principled leaders in this country. That's why we elect the most inhumane, disgusting degenerates that we can. People like Ron DeSantis and Trump.
Right.
Those are the people,
and
the liars, the narcissists, the fascists, the racists,
and
the most sick, low-life, foul people you can imagine is who, if you're straight white Christian.
Right.
Man,
and so that's people. Why... And let me see. His channel is
Dixon White.
That's his name. Oops. His name is Dixon White. What he literally just said is who we have in office, and we're trying to replace them now. But we can't replace them with foreigners. Not originally born in this country. The reason why they did that, because everything Dixon White said was true, but Cenk might not have bad intentions, but what if somebody else does have bad intentions? Those people had bad intentions when they created this United States. And the reason they created it like that is so nobody else would come in and do what the hell they did to us. So do you want to change it and let people from Czechoslovakia come in and be the president? You want people from Germany to be the president? Because see, they created that. So those very Britain, you want Britain to someone from Britain to come over here and be our president? Because if you let in enough immigrants, this is the Jews will not replace us chant. Switch the name out. Blacks will not replace us. Jews will not replace us. Turks will not replace us. Just switch the name out. Because this is why Cenk running and getting all the notoriety is going to make people put in Trump. Trump wants Germans to replace you. But white people think, no, I got the land and money and he needs me. He needs my votes. Not when he get in and change the Constitution. You nut. He's already selling secret documents to other countries for money. This is why they made that like that. Because they knew that they were going to steal, rape, plunder, enslave. And they didn't want anybody else coming from those other countries that they came from. Immigrants themselves to North America, Turtle Island originally, to come in here and say, yeah, we stole it from you. We're not going to make laws that happen, so you come and steal it from us. So people that left their country for a reason. They left their country because they don't have the freedoms. And one thing Cenk said, you have 70 of us in the army that got the medal the highest medal that you could give in the army, the Purple Heart or whatever it was. But yet we're second class citizens. You need us to fight for you. No, Cenk, we don't need you and the people that are in the army to fight for us. You came to this country. You came to this country for the freedoms that you don't have in your country. You came to this country for the opportunities that you don't have in your country. You came to this country for the land, the ability to buy land, which you cannot do in your country of origin. So it's only right that you should be in the army and fight to keep it safe. But they come over here and take it from us, they're taking it from you. And when you all took that oath to become citizens, you took an oath to give up your country and your country's laws and your country's rules. And you took an oath to obey the Constitution of the United States, the laws and the rules of the United States. You gave it up when you came here, when your parents brought you here. They said, no, you're a child. We know what we want for ourselves and for you and for our grandkids. And we're going to leave Turkey. We're going to leave China. We're going to leave Taiwan. We're going to leave Jamaica. We're going to leave Venezuela. And we're going to get in line. We're going to become immigrants. And the United States is going to be our country going forward because we have liberties. We have rights. We have a constitution that protects us. Federally, whatever state we live in, there's state rights that constitutionally that protect us. And we don't have that in our country of origin. Our country of origin, the government can come in, take my kids, take my money, take my land, take my dignity. Right? So that's why they came here. That's why they're still coming here. So now you want to go and change the document. Article 1. Section 1, clearly, this part of the Constitution is still valid. And what it specifically says, no person except a natural-born citizen or a citizen of the United States at the time of the adoption of this Constitution shall be eligible to the office of president. Neither shall the person be eligible to that office who has not reached the age of 35. It said attained at the age of 35 years and been 14 years a resident within the United States. So even if you moved here and you was 35 and you became a migrant, an immigrant, you would still have to be here how many years before you could become the president? There is a reason for that. 14, right? You've been here 14 years, Jake? Probably have. Nothing in this changed with the 14th Amendment. The 14th Amendment was created because they had black people that they brought here and labeled us as black. And we had no rights. We were supposed to live in servitude forever, Cenk. So it really wasn't even written for you. But it does apply to you. 14th Amendment. Now let me tell you why. And then I'm going to go. Do you see this? Bill of Attainder and ex post facto laws. The Constitution cannot be altered. It can't be amended. You can add a section of amendments to the original Constitution, Cenk, and anybody else that comes to this country. And he went to college. You didn't learn this in school or in college? Congress has in here that they cannot make any ex post facto laws based on someone making a claim that they are being punished. Just to clear this up for anybody who's thinking, whether you're a black person, a white person, and you support Cenk, whether you're a Muslim or whomever you are, a statute that has been held to be civil and not criminal in nature cannot be deemed punitive as applied to a single individual. The United States Constitution is not punishing you. So you can sit on TV and say, I'm being punished. I'm a second-class citizen. You're not. These laws of the United States Constitution, they were not made as a punishment. So you can't come along years later and say, I'm being punished. Likewise, an act permitting the cancellation of naturalization certificates obtained by fraud prior to the passage of a law was held not to impose a punishment, but instead simply to deprive the alien of his ill-gotten privilege, which is why I'm against migrants, because migrants lie and use fraud to come into this country. And then when they go through the court process, taking up all our resources and time to do that, and it's figured out that, oh, you know what, your case doesn't fit, you got to go back home. They're somewhere lost in America using someone else's social security, someone else's ID. Because you can't legally be in the United States. So you're not going to get Social Security number. You don't get a Social Security number anyway. You get that card that allows you to work. I think. So the bills of attainder say that the United States Congress cannot change it. And what Cenk said that, oh, well, the judges, the people are going to get behind me, and then the judges are going to change it. It's my niece. And the judges are going to change the law. You know, let me have my day in court. You're not entitled to a day in court to challenge the United States Constitution. I believe if you do that, you had to sign an oath when you came into this country. And they gave you a pamphlet that said what you could do and what you could not do. You can challenge a law that denies you a right or a privilege or a protected right. You cannot challenge the United States Constitution that did not grant you something and that is not a punishment. Good luck in your efforts to do it, but I wanted to explain it to people so that they wouldn't get an idea in their head because they like, you know, your show and your show is popular, that the United States is doing something wrong. No, the thieves that stole this country, they created a document called the United States Constitution so no one else could steal it from them. Now, they're all dead. They all dead. Ain't nobody alive from the 1800s, 1700s, late 1700s, and 1800s. They're all dead. And the reason why North America is still North America is because nobody from China could come over here and become our president. Nobody from Russia or Germany could come over here and be our president. No one from Switzerland could come over here and be our president. So it was done for a reason, Cenk. I do support you running. I do support you being on the ballot, but people are going to vote for Cenk. You go ahead and you vote for him. I heard some people say, oh, it's going to take away. You're going to make sure that Donald Trump beats, Biden. And Biden's not going to get it because, you know, somebody has to get 50%. I hope nobody gets 50%. But then they go to who got the highest votes. None of these men are good for our country. None of them. And if you don't want to vote for me, there's 14 pages of people that's running in the United States. Let's help elevate one of those people instead of the two that the rich people who own all the media tell us who we should be voting for. Have a good day.